Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today we continue our class Power Systems BEJ 20603. Okay, we continue chapter Balanced Three Phase System. Okay, Balanced Three Phase System. Previously we have discussed about introduction to three phase system, how to generate power and voltage in three phase system. So today we will discuss about three-phase source connection. Three-phase source connection. Okay, for three-phase source connection, basically we have three types of three-phase source connection. Number one, we call it a three-phase three-wire star connected source. Okay, three-wire star connected source. And four wire star connected source, and the last one we call it three wire delta connected source. Okay, basically we have a star connected source and delta connected source, but for star connected source we have a three wire and we have a four wire. Okay, this is the example of the three wire star connected source, three wire star connected source. Okay, this why we call it a three wire, because we have a three line. Okay, red, yellow and blue, R, Y and B. Okay, so we have a three wire. Okay, phase R, phase Y and phase B, and then we have a common point. Okay, so this is our, for example, this is our generator. Okay, phase red, yellow and blue. Okay, so that we have a line red, line yellow and line blue. Okay, so in this case we have a voltage supply. Okay, this terminal supply to the load, so supply the line voltage. Okay, we have a line voltage. Okay, okay, next we have a four wire. Okay, four wire star connected source, or four wire Y connected source. What is the main difference between 4 wire and 3 wire for star connected source? In 4 wire, we have a neutral wire. So in this case, we have 4 wire, which is 3 live wire, red, yellow, blue. This is the terminal of the live wire. And then we have a neutral wire. So in this case, our generator can supply the line voltage. Line voltage mean the voltage, the potential difference between two lines. For example, V, R, Y. Okay, the line voltage between line R and Y. This system also supply the phase voltage. For example, V, R, N. Okay, the voltage between R and N. For example, in the three-phase system, for example, for distribution system, we have a 400 volt and then we have a 230 volt. Okay, for three-phase system, okay, we have a line-to-line voltage 400 volt. Okay, line-to-line voltage 400 volt, and for certain application, commonly we use a single-phase voltage 230 volt. Okay, this mean that we have a phase voltage. Okay, line to the voltage difference between line and neutral wire. So in this case, this kind of configuration is more flexible lah, depend to the application, for single phase or for single phase for the low voltage, and we can use the line to line voltage for high voltage application lah. Yeah, it's depend on the application. Okay, next we have a three wire delta connected source. Okay, we have three wire. This is our delta connected source. Okay, let's say this is our phase red, yellow and blue. Okay, this is line R, Y and B. Okay, connected to the load. Okay, in this case we have a three wire. Okay, we have a three wire R, Y and B connected to the load. Okay, the advantage of the advantage of the delta connected system actually is high reliability. For example, in the distribution transformer, okay, if one of the primary winding is failed, okay, in the distribution transformer, the secondary will still produce a voltage on the on all three phases, okay. The only requirement is that the remaining or the remaining two phases must be able to carry the load, okay. So in the distribution system circuit configuration, okay, the circuit configuration used by the distribution system to supply the three-phase power to the industry and residential consumer depends to the some extent on the type and size of the load to be connected. Basically, for circuit configuration, several method of connection are possible for the distribution. Number one, we call it a three-phase three-wire. Okay, we can use a three-wire and three-phase four-wire. For three-wire, we have a star-connected, star-delta connected, delta-star connected. Okay, for three-phase four-wire, we have a star-star connected. Okay. Okay, three-phase system may not have a neutral wire. Okay, may not have a neutral wire. Three-phase three-wire, of course, we don't have a neutral wire. A neutral wire allow the three-phase system to use a higher voltage while still supporting the low voltage single-phase appliances. Okay, depend to the application. In high voltage distribution situation, it is common not to have a neutral wire as the load can simply connected to the phases, phase to phase connection, which is line to line connection lah. For example, connection between red to the yellow voltage, okay, in the high distribution situation lah. Okay, this is the advantages and disadvantages of the delta connected three-phase voltage source. Okay, what is the advantage of the delta connected three-phase voltage source? Okay, the main advantage of the delta connected source actually is delta connected three-phase voltage sources give greater reliability in the event of the winding failure than Y connected sources. Okay, that's the advantage of the delta connected source. And the disadvantages of delta connected source, okay, delta connected three-phase voltage source, delta connected sources have large line current, okay, have a large line current than Y connected sources to deliver the same amount of power. That's the disadvantage. Okay, that's all for today. Okay, see you again.